Okay, you ready?
I mean, we haven't really talked about what we're going to talk about.
Yeah, that's the point.
Okay, ready as I'll ever be.
Welcome to a very special episode of 321 with the most special guest ever, at least in my opinion. Sorry, all other guests. Joining us today is my beautiful wife, Kelli.
Hi, that's me, I guess.
So we were talking this morning, and why did we even bring this up? I forget.
You were showing me pictures of boots from Goodwill.
Yes.
Women's boots.
Yes.
That you wished were men's boots so you could buy them for LARPing.
Yeah, I was lamenting that the thrift store always has a lot of great options, LARP appropriate, and cool looking boots, and it's not a problem that they're women's, it's just that they're much smaller. They only run in about a 10s women, which is like an 8 in men's. They don't fit me. It's a problem.
It's not that you're opposed to wearing women's shoes.
I'm not ashamed to admit I tried a couple on, and unfortunately it didn't fit. So I was showing you the pictures of them to show you how cool they were, and then you said something. What did you say?
Well, I felt like I was admitting a secret, yeah. Which is that I've been wondering if maybe I would become interested in LARPing, I guess. Yeah.
For those of you who don't know, she has never LARPed. I wouldn't say she was strongly opposed to it. Just more of a disinterest, not her thing kind of thing.
It's not disinterest, just lack of interest, I guess.
They're different.
Yeah. Disinterested, like, sounds more opposed, I guess.
Okay.
But it's been, like a little nugget of interest.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know, maybe I liked a pair of the boots you were showing me, and I was like, ooh. Popped in my head, like, oh, that would be cool for my LARP character someday, and then I felt like I had to admit it out loud.
Much to my jubilation.
Yeah, you were, like, looking like you were trying to stay calm, but your eyes were, like, widened. Really? Tell me more.
Exactly. So now here we are. Tell us more. So we just started kind of talking about, you know, the ins and outs of that and what you were thinking and what either led to that change or at least it seemed like a change to me. I said, well, maybe we should record this because it sounded interesting to me at least.
Let's see.
And it is, because I had said, you know, part of what I'm hoping to do with this podcast is maybe not so much, like, change misconceptions, that's maybe too big, but at least, you know, appeal to people who have never LARPed, and they may enjoy it if they understood it a little better, I guess. So broadening the community and more people involved in the hobby. Because it may not be what they think, I guess. So that led to kind of different questions and discussions we were having about LARP, and I was actually just super curious about what your thoughts were and what you would do if you LARPed. And we kind of talked a little bit about that, like, if you made a character, what would the motivations be? So, so why don't we start with what you do know about LARP, or your perception of it as of right now. No right or wrong answers, whatever you think.
I don't know. I feel like that's a big question. So, what do I know about LARP? So, I know that, well, you do it, and you like it, and you have a lot of people that you're meeting through it. So, there's this nice sense of community, seems like. I mean, I was challenged recently because I thought it was all, like, big long weekend events, but then you went to that one day one. But it does kind of seem like it's like you go to a specific location and there's like a world with a whole bunch of rules that somebody decided and figured out, and you act like you're part of that world. I mean, this all feels so basic to just say out loud. But
sure, yeah, fine. We all started somewhere.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah.
And this could be wrong, but you know, a lot of people, it's kind of a progression in my mind, you know, you see a movie or a show or a comic book, a book, and you play a game or you play a video game, and then you find out, oh, people do this themselves, dressed up in the woods, real time, live action. And then some people say, yes, that's for me. Some people say, no thanks. And then there's a lot of people in between, probably, you know.
Well, maybe then a better way to start talking about it is kind of how I've been exposed to LARP, which probably was like Renaissance fairs, right? That was what came to mind when you were talking. Like, we went as a family when I was a kid, and I remember my dad being, I thought he was like super goofy, but I was young enough, it was cool and funny that he was pretending to speak like he was back from medieval times, and my mom was laughing hysterically and loved it, but also like way too embarrassed to participate, and I was probably more on that end.
I say history repeats itself.
Yeah. But, you know, then as I got a little older, I guess teenage years, my sister and I went a few times on our own, like without the rest of the family. And since it was just the two of us and we didn't know anyone else there, we got costumes and we pretended to be part of that time and even tried some accents and interacted with people. It was really fun.
Yeah, it was so really you've LARPed, fun. Basically.
What? No, I mean,
I would LARP light, maybe, but...
LARP light, yes. Yeah, that was pretty fun. The costume building was fun, and I always felt like I didn't know what to say. She seemed better at it. I don't... You always say that some of my Harry Potter world stuff is kind of LARPish, like when, again, my sister and I went to Harry Potter World, or Wizarding World of Harry Potter at Universal Studios. And yes, maybe while we were there a few times, we pretended like we were actually at Hogwarts and tried to have conversations together. Yeah. And it was fun because some of the people who work there, you know, they pretend to be actually part of the world. So that's kind of cool. And then my real exposure has been just watching you peripherally, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Helping me with various tasks and preparation.
Yeah. I don't know. What have I helped you with?
Oh, you helped me get my armor ready once or twice.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, that was fun. You couldn't figure out how to tie them together.
Yeah. Cool. So that's not a bad basis. Had you ever seen any TV shows or movies that even had it in? Or, I mean, you've seen pictures, at least, of my games. And have you ever seen any YouTube videos or anything like that?
No, we watched a video. It was like a news thing.
Oh, yeah.
Vice,
yeah.
Yeah. That was interesting to watch. That was early in when you were getting back into LARP.
Oh, yeah. So you've seen, you can picture what it's like, though, more or less.
I think so. Yeah.
How can you picture yourself doing that?
That's the harder, yeah. That's the harder part. It's the whole, like, thinking on your feet thing. Being a character, improv, I mean, that theater-ish aspect. I was never on stage or really an actress, which is funny because I'm a little dramatic, but I'm not like, I don't know.
Center of attention versus background, maybe, or?
You wouldn't put it that way. No, I think it's probably more the creativity piece in the moment. Being somebody kind of different than yourself. Like, that's not something that I've done a whole lot of, I guess. Does that make sense?
Sure.
I don't mind attention, but I want it on me as my actual person. I've never really been a character. And,
sure.
Yeah.
Now that you just mentioned, it makes me think it's a strange thing in LARP that I don't know that you could really separate the two. I mean, you can in a way. Like, you wouldn't be proud of me, Ashton, for slaying a monster necessarily, but for me, role playing as a character, that's still kind of like you're saying, you have to role play it yourself. So if you're I guess what I'm getting at is if you're impressed with someone's role playing, then you may be impressed with their character, but you also are impressed with them saying those things and coming up with those things, you know. So so even if it's not you, I mean, unless it's like a story you're telling that your character did that you didn't really do, that somebody's like, wow, that's amazing. I mean, there's still You know, I think a lot of things get appreciated at the game I go to, people's creativity as far as their costumes and makeup and their storytelling and acting. You know, a group appreciates those things, so they get recognized and praised, I think, you know, outside of the game. So I don't know if that was exactly what you meant or not.
Well, it brings up that interesting kind of dichotomy that I always talk about when you talk about LARP and people's characters, that, sure, you know, it's hard for me not to imagine a psychoanalysis, I guess, and not of people, obviously, not psychoanalyzing people I don't know, but it's just such an interesting way to express kind of unspoken desires or, you know, fears or, you know, so in some ways I can imagine people really wanting to be like, oh, this is my character, you know, and it's just my character. But in other ways, it's so intricately tied, you know, I can't imagine someone building a character that is not a projection of some version of their inner self, I guess.
Sure. Yeah. And I've talked to people who've loved a long time, had a very similar conversation. They more or less said the same thing you just said.
Maybe there's a piece of that at this point in my life too, that it's a little hard for me to get out of my own way and just allow myself to act out those fantasies that feel hidden or something. You know, I think there is, sure, there's a certain degree of, I was going to say childish. This sounds negative, but I guess I mean in the like disinhibited way.
Sure. Well, like, we talked about that before. Like Joe's mentioned that a lot of it harkens back to, you know, childhood,
goats
in the woods. Yeah,
and
imagination.
Yeah,
and stuff, so.
But in that whole, like, before you were fully aware of social constructs and, like, norms,
sure, yeah,
I guess, that's really probably what it is when I was talking about theater and improv. It's, I feel that I've always been a little too inhibited. I'm too aware,
sure,
of, like, myself and my responses and to kind of just let loose. But maybe that's what's appealing, too. I mean, if you can get past that, but I don't know if there are just certain people like me who can't.
Maybe. I mean, it might take a long time. And honestly, I think I felt the same way getting back into it. Yeah, it took me a few events, you know, before I felt comfortable with a lot of things. You know, there's, like you said, a whole world you have to, like, kind of immerse yourself in. And at least for me, felt like I should know a little bit of the history, the lore and stuff. If somebody says something about, oh, hey, you're from this kingdom, blah, blah, blah. And you're like, oh, I didn't know that. You know, but again, it is stuff that just kind of gets in the way if you let it, unfortunately. And now I feel much more comfortable. You know, it's only been about a year, so we've been back into it. But now I think that's a very common thing. You know, even people who have LARPed a long time probably get more comfortable faster. But you'd be surprised, I think, is what I'm trying to say, is how common that is.
Sure. I mean, now that I think about it, we've had, like, at work retreats, improv as a sort of team building, and it's almost like pitched as a personal therapy, right? Like an anecdote to that self-criticism, sort of inner voice, to just practice kind of letting it go and just making decisions and going with it on the fly.
Sure.
And the whole piece of, like, I mean, this was just kind of comedy improv. It wasn't LARP related, but there's a lot of...
Same thing, really.
Yeah. Yeah, I was just saying, I'm sure there's a lot of similarities, but to kind of get out of your own way is really what's best for, like, the team and the group. And
sure.
I mean, those are great things to practice. There's so many things, I think, when you tell me stories about LARP, and I'm like, oh, those are really great skills to practice. You know, having courage and being spontaneous and
taking risks,
cooperating,
yeah.
Taking risks and learning to cooperate with others. And I think for some people, like, I mean, taking risks, but, like, putting themselves out there in a social way, even, I'm sure that's good, as long as you're practicing those skills and hopefully internalizing them to your real self also.
Sure. But, I think a lot of that happens.
Yeah. But we're getting a little off track.
Yeah, I was going to say, let's back way up.
Yeah, now I'm just talking theoretically what I think about LARP, which is much more comfortable for me than actually talking about doing LARP for some reason.
Sure, whoa. Hey, let's take it slow.
Ooh.
Want you to feel comfortable.
Oh my gosh.
So, yeah, we started with the costume because that was very appealing, fun, you know. And it's a important first step. You know, I sort of called it character creation. I think you're more just worried about the outfit, which kind of go hand in hand. And hey, I'm still working on my costume every event. I like to add something, or I spend a lot of my time looking on the internet at other cool, you know, outfits and stuff just for kind of inspiration and to keep the ideas in my head, you know.
Well, yeah, the style part is fun. The idea of playing around on Pinterest and piecing things together into a character. And even, I was saying earlier, the writing of a character and a backstory is appealing.
Mm-hmm.
But then the, like, embodiment of it, I guess, is the intimidating part. You know, like, if I were to create a character and wear the costume and, like, take pictures or something that go with this story I wrote, that's not, like, as scary, right? But if I have to then become that character and think in the moment of what they would say and do and what their motivations are, that's is more intimidating. So how do you move past that?
That's a great question. Let me know when you figure out.
Ah, geez.
I don't know. For me, it is just kind of part of the game. Like, I'm playing a game and I want to feel like I'm doing well at the game. You know what I mean? Like, that's what it is for me, at least, I think. Just answering off the top of my head without internalizing it super long.
So is there, like, a competitiveness that propels you kind of forward? Like, you want to do well and...
I mean, only against myself. That makes sense. I don't know if that's competitiveness
or... So you want to, like, win the game.
No, not win the game. I want to feel like I'm doing well. I want to feel competent, you know?
I guess I don't mean, like, be the winner, but, like, you want to succeed at the game.
I feel like I'm doing well, and feel like I'm LARPing well, I guess, you know, like, which would, to me, would mean role-playing well, getting into character well, conveying and interacting in this community, player base, you know, that people enjoy playing with me and having me along in the adventures. That's probably secondary more than me just having fun. So yeah, I like that when I feel like I'm getting into character and I'm enjoying being that character, I guess, probably more than anything. Which is one of the reasons I like my newer character is I spent a little more time coming up with things I thought might be interesting to see happen and kind of simplified it. Like, you know, he's kind of like this, and this is one of his main motivations, and he's really into this, so I can focus on that. And maybe, again, being more comfortable with the game and the world, I maybe knew there was a lot of opportunities for him to be very interested in learning and researching and studying things, you know. So when he showed up to town, there was lots of new people to talk to, and everything was fascinating to him, you know. So that was fun and interesting to me, I guess.
So is it just you have to have a character you're excited enough about being?
Yeah, that helps. Yeah, I mean, it really comes down to what are you trying to get out of it, I guess. Because I've talked to people, I don't know if I know anyone or play with anyone, but I definitely have talked to people who have said, you know, some people just like to show up and fight with fake weapons, and what they call them, stick jockeys or whatever. You know, they like just kind of going out there and either pretending or not, you know, kind of like just paintballish, amateur sports kind of thing, like just going out in the woods, having fun, sparring. Physical, yeah, that kind of thing. And to add a setting and costumes is kind of just maybe bonus to them, you know, to watch Lord of the Rings and actually be a dwarf and go out and hit people with an axe is pretty fulfilling to them, you know. And they'll still interact and use a voice or whatever. But yeah, I mean, that's kind of one of the things I think I'm trying to get at this show. Like, is there a right way or wrong way to LARP? Not necessarily. What was your question? how do you get past, if you're not necessarily wanting to create a character and become the character and act out that character?
No, I'm getting from that stage of like, okay, I could imagine a cool character that would be fun to be, but then getting past that step of like on paper, real life LARP, I guess. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Sure, totally. I mean, you can always start like that, you know, once you get to that point, you can write out some stories, and that starts to develop the character. I think one of the cool things about LARP, again, I don't know if this will answer your question, but it popped in my head. One of the cool things about LARP is it takes a bit of the total control away from you. And so now
that's probably what I don't like.
And so now you're no longer...
Everyone that knows me is laughing.
Yeah. You're no longer this omniscient writer who is controlling everything in the world that's happening to the character. You're now just the character who has to react to the world, you know? So there's other players who will influence things and interact with you that you have to respond to. There's the environment and the monsters and townsfolk and the NPCs all come and interact with a character, and now something happens and you have to decide, what does my character do? Maybe some people don't look at it that way. It's how I look at it, I guess. And that's, I think, part of the... There's a fun creativity spontaneity about that. You've now become... You're part of a community, live world storytelling, where your character is part of that story. It's no longer just, you know, black and white text on a screen. Like, you don't know what's going to happen. I think that's a really fun part for people. And part of a game or watching a movie, you know, like, you know, part of the first enjoyment is you don't know what's going to happen. And then something happens, so it's unique and surprising. And so that's half the fun of LARP, I think, is you don't know what's going to happen. And you're not sure how you're going to react necessarily. You can prepare all you want. May go how you want, may not. You may succeed, you may fail.
See, okay, we're going to get really deep here now because, I think I'm realizing what thought I had when you were talking was, I never thought I'd say this about LARP, but that sounds like too much just like life.
Sure.
Like, if I'm going to LARP, don't I want it to be an escape from real life? And to me, that kind of means like, oh, things will work out. Right? But that's not the case in LARPing. You could actually die. I mean, your character could die in LARP and like... I don't know. You could, like, make enemies, you know, like, bad things can happen. Like, if it was, like, here is a, I guess I want a world that's more of a bubble, like a safer, happier kind of, I don't know, world.
Sure.
And so.
That kind of, like, LARP might be out there.
Maybe. I know, but that sounds so tame. I know.
I was going to say, cupcake LARP or something.
Yeah. I don't know. I guess, I mean, I'm not saying that's all of it, but when you were talking, that was kind of what came to mind, that is like, yeah, on paper, like you said, you can control it. You can, you know that there's going to be a happy ending because you're writing it, right? But like, once you put yourself in a world that someone else created and is literally like kind of controlling behind the scenes, you know, you don't really know what's going to happen. And if you make a mistake, it could actually lead to like a negative result for your character, and that feels a little too much like life. Like, why do I have to do that in my regular life? You know?
Yeah, I think that probably is something a lot of people think and they may not even be aware of, which leads to something that happens fairly commonly in my experience, where not so much of the game we're playing now, but a lot of people might hang out at the inn or not go explore for that fear. Like, I don't want something bad to happen to my character, so I'm probably only going to go with safe bets or when everybody's doing something. You know what I mean? Which, again, there's nothing wrong with that, but it does, you know, there's a little bit of risk-reward. Like, you may miss out on something that was super fun or not be rewarded for your effort or something like that. But to get back to what you're saying, I think a good staff can judge that, you know? Like, typically in a game, there's a progression, you know, like, especially a video game, there's a learning curve, you know, it starts off very easy, usually tells you what to do in a video game, and that progression of increasing challenge and whatnot is just part of the game and how they work, and I think, I don't know if all LARPs do that, I think a good LARP would probably at least try to do that to you, like, you know, start off a little softball, like, I think most LARPs would try to have new players, especially, do something where they're pretty sure they're going to win. You know, people don't want to just be handed, typically, don't want to just be handed something. They want to earn it. And they maybe want to suffer a little bit, but they ultimately want to win, you know. Mm-hmm. That's kind of what I think I could probably generalize, say most people, that's their attitude.
Sure, I'd put myself in that group.
Yeah, and so I think, you know, that's a hard thing. This is just kind of guessing what staff might think, because I've never really staffed a game. But I have been like a dungeon master and things like that, you know, for tabletop gaming. You kind of want that little, you want options as far as like, hey, this is probably going to be easy, or a new player mod, they sometimes call it. Meaning they take anyone that's new all together to do something. And sometimes there's other people who have been there longer, but it's generally probably going to be a little easier. But they want to keep it real, you know, like they're not going to just give it to you necessarily. So they want you to at least try and do your best. But they're not going to, ideally, I guess what I'm trying to say is a staff should probably not throw anything at you that they're pretty sure you're going to lose at, unless there's something else involved where someone's going to show up and save you, or, you know, some kind of story element or whatever. But
so you're saying you're a little more protected than what I'm actually thinking?
Probably. Yeah. I mean, I wouldn't say you always are. And I know a lot of staff I play with listen to this, so they're going to hear that and say, oh, we're going to
let's jail Ashton. Yeah.
No. But
you're saying it is a game, and it sounds like usually, you know, everybody wants for people to be enjoying themselves.
Exactly. Right? I think a good staff tries to keep that at a priority, and it can be a tricky thing. It's one of those hard to please all the people all the time.
Sure.
But generally, yeah, a good staff will know we want players to have fun and enjoy themselves, and they take feedback and whatnot. And so, you know, nobody enjoys a challenge that they never could have won in the first place, but they really enjoy a challenge that they maybe thought they couldn't or a little nervous about overcoming, and then they did. And I've had plenty of encounters that we quote-unquote succeeded, but I kind of came back from like, man, I wish I had done this a little better, or something had gone a little better, the fight had been a little better, someone hadn't died or whatever, you know. So, yeah, it's not always like perfectly turned out how I wanted. There's been some like close calls or, you know, whatever. But again, that's yourself and the player base, and then how your staff kind of reacts and monitors things. And so again, that's why I like our games. I think we have a good staff that tries to be aware of that stuff, and they have a pretty large staff, I think, and they're diverse, so they can kind of come up with different things to appeal to different people. But anyway,
I mean, it sounds like really all I'm saying is that my tendency to self-criticize is maybe the root cause of why I would feel nervous about doing a LARP. And the remedy is to put yourself in situations where you have little control, right?
Sure.
And maybe practice it in a, you know, this is, I mean, you know, I said it sounds like real life, so why would you do it? But it's not real life. I mean, you're not actually going to die. You know, there is a layer of kind of protection to your ego, right? Because it's not actually you failing at life. It's a character version of you failing in a LARP. So in that way, it's actually could be a good therapeutic sort of experience.
Sure.
You can get over that hurdle of just do it and try it out. But I don't know if I'm there. Yeah.
Yeah. Only one way to find out.
Oh, jeez. I mean, and then there's the whole piece of it is an extensive hobby, right? Like,
sure.
And then I think that was actually what I was talking about this morning was I'm starting to be able to imagine a time in my life where I have more free time. I have just not had the mental or, you know, physical energy to entertain kind of such the idea of starting such a like extensive hobby, I guess. And now maybe, you know, there's time and space going to open up for something that's more of a creative pursuit, but it just doesn't seem like people do LARP casually, right? So it's like once you get started, you have to keep going regularly so your character gets the points or whatever and moves forward, yeah, you're just like, yeah. and it's travel, you know, for us right now, it's quite a bit of travel, right? And we have a young son. How would we ever possibly both of us go? Like, that's just crazy. Sure. So there's kind of this logistical side of like, costs a lot of money, takes a lot of time to make a full costume, especially if there are like weapons or armor or those crazy things you've done involved, and then just going to the events.
Sure.
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe not everybody does it as intensely as you, but this has been my version that I've seen. So.
Sure. No, you're definitely making me wonder about that.
Are there casual LARPers?
Yeah,
you should get them on your podcast.
Yeah, I think I made that joke about something about casual LARPers, and I said, oh, is there such a thing? In an episode once. But yeah, I think it's getting to the point where there are a lot of LARPs going on that you probably could find, you know, your right flavor or pace version of it. So there might be LARPs out there that just have a group who are a little more casual, or at least accept a casual player, and they're not as strict about your costume or staying in character all the time. You know, I bet that's probably
just
out there.
That. But what about the fact that it seems like every time you go, you're up till like 4 a.m. Like, that does not sound appealing to me. Is there a LARP where I can get enough sleep on a weekend? Because that's important.
Yeah. Well, I mean, like you said, the game I went to, Runes of Destiny, it's only on a Saturday and they go from 9 to 10. So, you know, especially if you were local to that one, you'd be home in bed by 11 maybe. And you can always, you know, I was thinking about, you said something about control. Like, you really kind of do have total control in some way. Like I said, if you want to hang out in the inn and not risk your character's life, you have that control. If you want to go to bed earlier, you have that control. You might be people fighting a dragon outside your hut, but or cabin.
Yeah, what are you paying for then?
All right, yeah. Well, actually, something you said earlier, I was thinking like, well, maybe we just have to have like a practice run at a park for like an hour or two. You know, that's like easy into it, so it's not like, you know, 48 hours, four-hour drive away for $50.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's good. Like, if you can get a small group of friends or whatever and just go out and have fun, practice. You can even try out a few different characters that way, you know. You can see, do I like this style of weapons? Do I want no weapons? Do I want to throw packets? Do I want to sing? You know, whatever. Shoot Nerf guns. Whatever. So, I mean, that's probably, if you're not sure but interested, that's a good way. First step, maybe. I mean, I would start with create a character. And I'm speaking more of a general sense as far as, like, anyone listening. Like, when I said about you could probably find a game that'll match what you're looking for a little more, you know. Either a more casual crew or less strict about costume, and or we could start one.
I was gonna say $1 million business. Well, maybe not $1 million, but
$100 idea.
Yeah, yes, $100 business idea. So exciting.
Yeah.
LARP 101. I mean, is there, are there just groups you can get a little taste of LARP?
Mm-hmm.
You know, without the commitment and pressure of a full blown 48-hour LARP.
Yeah, maybe. Anyways, episode's more about you and your interest. So, let's just start with the costume. Have you ever, have you thought about what kind of costume or how you'd want to look at all?
Well, there was a time a few years ago, I think we were like pulling ideas out of a hat for date night or something, and we were staying home. And you suggested, let's draw up some characters. Do you remember this?
I do remember. I don't remember why we were doing it, but I do remember.
We were trying to do something together and, like, not watch TV, I think.
Yeah.
And you were just getting back into some D&D. Mm-hmm. I think it was more like we were thinking of it in a D&D way than a LARP way. Anyway, so I guess I just always picture it the way I drew that.
Sure.
Which was kind of like, had a Robin Hoodie, like a female Robin Hood kind of appeal with, like, I don't rem- remember at all, but like...
Mm-hmm. There was a hood.
Hooded.
Cape-ish.
Yeah, it wasn't like a cloak. I don't even think it was a cloak, because I think it had sleeves, but it had a big, like, hood that would make you kind of like a shaded figure. And you could be real stealthy, like. And
Should
like.
Hear your voice?
Yeah. And like laced up and like laced up boots and stuff. Yeah.
Love it.
Yeah. And, you know, like a fitted part so that you feel real girly and pretty and stuff.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Of course. Gotta have that. Oh, and we came up with the name Jade.
Yeah.
Because it was a spinoff of Ruby.
Oh. I don't know if I knew that.
Oh.
I thought it was just because you drew green or something. You said a green hood or something.
Yeah, well, no, that was all part of it.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
That's good. I like that stuff.
Yeah.
And then would you play a character that kind of style? The scout, ranger... Rogue, or is that just your look?
Oh, no, yeah, I mean, the story that I came up with back then was, like, yeah, kind of like a rogue, I guess, that, like, really was about protecting her family, right? Do you remember this at all?
Kinda.
Help me. And so it was, like, she was a thief, but really it was all for, you know, like, Robin Hood kind of thing, I guess. It's certainly not that original, but it was about, you know, like... about kind of sending money back to her family to survive or whatever. So this stealthy, sneaky...
Mm-hmm. But she had a persona or something that
people didn't know that. They just thought she was a thief.
Yeah.
Like a really good thief. Yeah.
Yeah, that was into just stealing for stealing's sake or money or wealth.
Right.
But there was a altruistic motivation, maybe.
Right.
Hidden.
Yes. Yeah, so even the character had this kind of duality.
Mm-hmm.
Which That's I good. Liked.
Yeah.
But then we were saying this morning, I mean, I go back and forth about actually like fighting. Like, do I really want to fight people? Sometimes I'm like, yeah, let's get that aggression out. It's fine. Other times it's like, I don't know. I'm not an aggressive person. Or I don't think I should be or something. I don't know. There's probably like a ton to go into there. But the idea came up of like, could you be doing LARP and be a pacifist? Like, could your character be a pacifist, and how would that fit into a LARP world?
Sure, which I said would be a super interesting character arc to me, to see how it played out and how it felt. How do you pull it off?
Does that put you at odds with everyone else, though, all the time? I don't know.
No, I don't think so. I mean, depends on the game, of course. I think as long as you weren't, like, trying to make everyone else a pacifist, you'd probably be all right. And as long as, like, I don't know, you didn't totally hold up the show or... I mean, I'm sure you'd come up with a reason that would annoy people, but I think for the most part, at least again in our game, people kind of respect how you decide to play your character. Only until you start hurting or annoying someone else does it become an issue.
Mm.
But every game's different, and I was thinking you might want a weapon, even if you're not into the combat. It's a little silly to not have something to at least defend yourself with, if need be. But again, if you chose the pacifist option, though, that would be, again, how would you protect yourself? Would you just always run? Would you maybe carry a shield? Would you just take any skills and spells that help you pacify people or get away or whatever, you know? Like, hinder but not harm. Like, that could be an interesting character. Might be difficult, especially for your first time playing. Again, if that's what you want to do, I tend to encourage people to try to play whatever they want. Again, I have problems with people who deliberately decide to play a-holes and people who are uncooperative and whatever. But again, if that's your choice, man, have at it, but I probably won't enjoy playing with you. I might appreciate it if you pull it off well, but...
I like the idea of having magic. Like, is there a way to be a pacifist where you use magic just to, like, distract people or confuse people?
Yeah, that's
you don't
a good
ever
character,
have to, like,
actually.
Hurt them or.
Sure.
But, you know, and then as pacifist, if you're distracting or confusing people so that they can get, like, ambushed by the people you're working with, like, that wouldn't work. You know, like, it. So, yeah, there's a lot to think about.
Your character is already more interesting than mine.
Is that true?
It sounds like has stronger convictions than my character. You just need a name and you're done. Mm. Yeah, and we sort of got into making a character and making a costume. That all sounds super fun, but then becoming that character and being at the game,
mm-hmm.
I asked, okay, you're going to kind of need a reason to be there if you want to go. Even though, I mean, dressing up, showing up at the inn, reason enough, I guess, if you want. And people to go, wow, her costume's cool. If that's all you want, then mission accomplished. You'll probably have a good weekend.
Well, it might be
But it might be a little boring after an hour or two.
It'd be helpful to hear what are some reasons people LARP. You know, you kind of gave two, you know, the whole, really it's about making a costume. It's like an elaborate cosplay. And then the people who are kind of seeing it as a sport. But what do you think are some other motivations? What actually gets people there?
Yeah, I think one of the things is sort of the storytelling and being part of it, you know, either just going and seeing what happens is interesting. Like, we play with a really good group of creative people who come up with interesting storylines.
Mm-hmm.
And I think a lot of people appreciate that, seeing these storylines play out, especially having the staff's characters show up and getting to interact with them and getting a story that way. You know, it's a one-on-one direct right to you. This is what's going on. This is what we need to have happen. This is what's happening in the world. So there is that kind of entertainment, live theater, you know, it could be like watching a show, but now you're part of it, you know? So it is just seeing a story play out, that I think is very enjoyable for people. And then getting to be a part of it and influence that story, is kind of one of the magical things about LARP. So seeing that story, playing a character is definitely super motivating for people. I think a lot of people want to go. I mean, definitely some people want to go and pretend to be somebody else for a day and a half. That's a common reason I hear a lot of people play video games and tabletop and LARP is an escape, you know, from reality. Mm. I mean, that's a low-level one, I think. But yeah, I think a lot of people, and again, this might just be our group, but I think we have a lot of theater and musical people who like to go and sort of, not perform, but yeah, like be another character and take on a persona and act out as, you know, a hobbit that likes to fight or a dragon person that plays the drums.
And that's
Did
different.
Did that give you any more answers?
Different than an escape?
No. I don't know what I'm saying. I guess that there's deeper things to it. Like, they want to escape, but, you know, you could just read a book or play a video game. It's definitely, you know, going out in the woods is part of it, you know, at least for me. I like being out in nature from time to time. And there's definitely the community. Like, you're probably going to meet some people who are probably cut from the same cloth as you if you're willing to do this. So I think that's one thing they like. You're probably going to meet people with similar interests and similar personality compatibility-ishness to them. So that's another reason. Yeah, I think a lot of people get into it because their friends say, hey, you should do this. And you either go with your friends or you end up making friends. They become your close friends or whatever. Not everyone, but so there's community, creativity. That's a big reason for it for me, as far as making all the stuff ahead of time and getting to use it, which is fun. Yeah, the aesthetics and look of a character is interesting, and seeing that in other people is fun for me too. Like, kind of like the Ren Faire, like people dressed up in not typical attire is interesting and fun. Yeah, for me, I definitely enjoy the game part of it. When it comes to the, you know, just numbers and stats of it, of like doing damage and hit points and armor and all that stuff and items and gold pieces and points or whatever, which is why, like, I wouldn't like a parlor LARP where it's all role playing and acting is a little less appealing to me, because that is just put on a costume, become a character and act, interactive storytelling. I mean, I don't know much about it. That's my very low-level knowledge of it, which could be cool, but it's not something I would probably do regularly and want to keep going to. I enjoy the game and the progression of it, and the setting, you know, of becoming an orc and having a cool sword and shield and armor. Mm-hmm. But I've always been into that since played D&D since I was 13 or whatever.
Well, I guess something that came to mind that probably is another reason some people do it is the puzzle aspect of it. Although you said it's maybe not as strong as I imagined, but like, I imagine there's this whole like figuring out what to do next kind of a thing. You know, like we just watched that movie Game Night and, you know, people do murder mystery dinner theater, you know, kind of things that people really enjoy because there's a piece of that game, right? Yeah. That it's like a puzzle game to figure out. Yeah, a
fun problem to solve.
Yeah.
Or an entertaining problem to solve or whatever. You know, there's escape rooms and whatever that have become popular now. That's basically LARPing, I think.
Yeah. So they're...
Yeah, overcoming
the mental
challenges.
Sort of side of the game and the physical side of the game that I could see would be appealing. And I guess it sounds like it would be hard to be interested in LARP if you didn't have a little bit of that, like, I enjoy kind of escaping real life for a little while, right? Mm-hmm. But most people have that. That's why we watch movies. That's why we read books, you know, but... Something about being an active part of it and not just being entertained has to be there for someone to want to do a LARP, probably, right?
Yeah, although Joe told a story about a LARP he went to that some people seem like they just came...
To watch other people?
Yeah, and sat in the inn. Mm. Yeah, kind of the spectator LARP.
Interesting. Okay, well, so really are kind of all types. Yeah.
So yeah, I don't know if that exhausts all the reasons, but there's, I'm sure, more. So anyway, what have you thought about that? If you made a character, knew a little bit minimally about the rules, and showed up to the game, what would you then want to do? I guess that was my question, is like, what would be enjoyable for you to do once you're there? Like, that's kind of the question to ask, I guess. And I think, again, like I said, because there's things you don't know what's going to happen... You may enjoy something you totally didn't expect. And so I think it's okay to show up with an expectation or, hey, I think I'll have fun if this happens or I get to do this, you know. But it's also okay to be like, I'm going to do this and see what happens.
It's a little hard for me to imagine. It's still a bit of a jump.
Sure.
In my mind to imagine me showing up at a LARP and then what my expectations would be.
Sure. Well, you can ask questions if...
But... I guess if I put myself in this very rudimentary character, thing that kind of felt exciting was kind of walking in the woods with a group of people and, I don't know, like having an adventure, right? Yeah. I guess there was, I mean, a little bit of like, it'd be kind of cool. Especially if so this all happened in the split 5 seconds that you just asked me this question, but I was, you know, feeling a little, I guess, protected by the group, you know, so it would have to probably be with people that I kind of already knew or that like I knew kind of knew how LARP worked, you know, or something, you know, not all experts so that I feel like a total novice, but a little bit of like safety in numbers kind of thing or something. Yeah.
Yeah, no, that's a great reason that I should have thought of to go on an adventure. Yeah. It's a very, probably basic LARP reason people LARP. Why do you LARP? I want to go in the woods and have an adventure. Yeah. And even if I'm just pretending and that guy's wearing a foam costume and they're duct taped weapons, it's still an adventure because I'm out in the woods having fun.
Yeah, it takes me... like wording it that way takes me back to like camping as a kid, and it felt that way walking in the woods with my family, you know, what's gonna happen, even if it's just we saw a deer run across the path, you know, or something. It was like that sort of feeling of
that mystery.
Yeah,
that's probably the word I should have said earlier when I was saying like you don't know what to expect and it's fun, like that's mystery.
There's a magic to the mystery that is if that part's appealing, I guess.
Sure.
As long as I feel protected and not...
Yeah,
like,
and that...
I don't know. There's something about, like, oh, someone is building this story. it's a little like puppet mastery, you know,
can't
and then
be
you
sure.
don't always like feel, what are they gonna do to me?
Sure, that's a haunted
house.
They're
just going to put us... Yeah, okay, all right, fair enough. They're just going to put us through the ringer because it's fun for them to watch, you know, or something.
I wonder that sometimes.
Know, yeah. So aside from all that, the mystery part, I guess, is... I mean, maybe I'm realizing that it's actually kind of appealing. If you put aside the inhibitions, right? You
know, right.
Get back to your kind of innocent... More innocent, I guess. Roots.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's a large appeal that people may not even be aware. Is they are trying to get back to that.
Yes.
Simpler time.
Oh, my gosh.
Uninhibited time. Freer time. Enjoyable time.
They're playing in the woods. I mean, I would hope exactly. that they would realize at some level.
Yeah. It's very serious. We're LARPing.
Yep.
Yeah. When you say protected, what do you mean? Like, protected from what? In what way?
Like looking like an idiot, I guess. Like a little bit of guidance, you
sure.
know?
Okay, that's what I thought you meant. Just
yeah.
If you meant physically or in-game, out-of-game.
Oh, no. More just like...
Socially protected?
So, we'll give it a really easy example. I hate video games that I don't know what to do next. I hate that feeling. And so when you are there... And you're like, try that ledge over there. And then I'm like, how did you see that? There was this whole hidden thing. It's so much more enjoyable for me. I never would have thought. I would just stood there like, duh, I don't know what to do next. This is no fun. I just feel stupid. That does not sound appealing to me. Like, I want someone there who
sure
can kind of... prod in the right direction, I guess, yeah. So that it's in...
I definitely feel that way sometimes at LARP. So.
Okay. Yeah, but I don't know why. It's super uncomfortable for me. I hate that feeling. Like,
sure.
I want to be moving forward and accomplishing something.
Yeah. Again, it depends on the game, but yeah, a lot of things in our game tend to be large group, so... And I definitely admit to sort of... stepping back and just letting someone else take care of it, because most of the town's here anyway, and there are people who have been playing this game longer and been LARPing a lot longer that they'll probably handle the situation better. I'm not saying it was super enjoyable for me, but at least where I was at that moment, I was like, I'm okay with kind of just seeing how this plays out, and it'll probably work out for everybody. Mm-hmm. You know, which is, again, that's not maybe the best attitude to have all the time. But certainly for a new player, someone getting into it, being comfortable standing back. And I kind of made this observation to Evan and Joe, how I thought it odd when people didn't take that attitude when they were newer and didn't know what was going on. And they were kind of injecting themselves, and it sort of was, at least in my observation, seemed odd or awkward, or like, you're kind of throwing off everything that's going on here. Like, out of game, that's what I was thinking. Like, this is throwing everything off. Like, you're about to derail everything.
Yeah, I don't want to be that. I don't want people to think that about me.
Yeah, but, I mean, if that was a person's choice to... And that was funny, like, I don't think they were necessarily new. They just wanted a character that acted that way. And I was like, well, all right, if that's what you're going to choose to do. And I definitely took that role a lot at first. It was kind of standing back and not jumping in right away. You do sort of not miss out, but you have to kind of be okay with going along with the show. If you're not interjecting and participating and people start doing something that's not how you would have done, you know, it's kind of your own fault if you didn't interject or didn't step up. So I see that happening sometimes where I'm like kind of going along and I'm like, I don't know if it's the best idea, but I didn't suggest anything. So I guess I got to go with it. And hopefully we're okay at the end. Like that's happened a few times. And again, that's sort of a life lesson there. Like, if you don't agree with what's going on, but you didn't say anything, then it's kind of your own fault. Or, you know, you always have the choice to be like, I'm just going to stick this one out, but you're not going to get to see the neat thing that happened.
I guess I didn't mean I want to be walking in the woods all passive. I just want,
no, I know what you
mean. I want some nudges, you know.
Sure. Yeah, I've definitely played some games with people who are good at picking up on that, and they're like, hey, why don't you talk to that guy? Or there is always a bit of like other things are going on, and if this doesn't move forward... Somebody's, you know, 100 yards away in the cold, dark, waiting for you to show up. So they tend to nudge, like, let's get some of it. But also letting the characters play and figure it out. And yeah, I think that would be good. Like, obviously, if you go, you'd have me and Evan and some of our friends that you could tag along and certainly interject, but we'd be there to help you out. And I think that's good. Like, it'd be hard to show up to a game where you don't know anyone, or, you know, unless you're just super LARP person. Mm-hmm. So, and I don't think anyone would have an expectation that you should be this, like, certain super in character, know all the right answers, do all the right things. Like that's a weird thing with our game, I think, is we have a pretty diverse group of people, especially LARP experience-wise. And I know some people who've LARPed a long time, they know when someone's kind of going down a path that's not going to work out for them, and they sort of just watch and let it happen, and then sometimes complain afterward. And I'm like, well, you just watched it happen. And it's a weird balance of, like, you should kind of let people learn their own lessons, or there's a fine line between, like, learn the hard way or learn from others' mistakes, or let someone have their experience. You know what I mean? Like, I think it tends...
Sure, you'd hope some people would be mentoring the newbies.
Sure,
yeah. Maybe that's what I want. I want someone to mentor me.
I think we have that at our game. And it's a very inclusive game in a lot of ways. So you'd have a chance to do as much as you want, really, you know. And I think people are definitely good with, like, bring people along. I think the deliverance of it, like how people mentor, is not always the best. I'll say, like, sometimes people just are straight to the point, blunt, and sometimes that's good, but it's not like a let me teach you kind of way. It's more like just do what I'm saying, you know. Like, that's how it comes across, whether they mean it that way or not.
Well, if you're doing something for fun, you don't want to feel like you're getting in trouble.
Yeah. So you're coming in June.
Yeah. 7 months pregnant, first LARP. That sounds great. In June.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys. That's a work in progress, I think.
Yeah. Well, and I was super interested, just your perspective, and that's who I want to talk to, is, like, people just on the fringe or just about to get in the water, you know? People waiting in the shallow end of knowing about it and thinking about, well, if I did this, what would I want to do, or that kind of thing. So that's what I was interested in hearing. Like, what are your current perceptions? How much do you know, or need to know, or want to know?
Well, it is interesting, as we've been talking, I don't think I realized just how much overlap there are with other kinds of hobbies. Like, you know, like the Renaissance fair kind of stuff, which also kind of makes me think of the, like, Civil War reenactment and then like these kind of new pop-up sort of things, like the escape rooms and the, you know, people hold mystery or murder dinner parties at home, you know, as part of game nights with friends, and then there's the D&D, kind of more like just mental exercise of the games. And then just improv and theater, and, you know, I didn't know much about that before we had that training a few times. But there actually is a lot of overlap. So it makes me wonder, like, what's different about LARPers versus people who are on the fringe of LARP in these other ways, you know, that it makes you think it's the fantasy aspect.
Yeah.
Yeah, that there tends to be this kind of magical world, right?
Mm-hmm.
And why is that appealing to certain people versus I want to get in character as a
Civil War general.
Right, exactly. Or yeah.
A crazy person in a play or whatever.
Yeah, yeah. An interesting question to keep thinking about.
Sure, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think you know this, but there are a lot of different settings. Like, if you're not that into orcs and elves, you know, there is post-apocalyptic. There are kind of, like, fancy Victorian-ish Downton Abbey-style LARPs. Just straight medieval, so it's not fantasy, but it's, you know, older times.
Mm.
There's space and sci-fi, kind of Star Wars. I mean, I know you're like, you like fantasy and Harry Potter and Lord of the Rings, so.
Yeah.
But for anyone listening, you know, for some reason, if they
somehow found this podcast. Didn't like fantasy.
Yeah. Well, yeah, we talked to Justin about that. You know, I think he likes that stuff too, but he likes Star Wars, so maybe doing a sci-fi space kind of thing might be more fun.
That's a good point.
And that was kind of something to think about as we're talking. Like, there's probably a good starter LARP for you or for anyone.
Yeah.
You know, like...
like a Harry Potter LARP.
Yeah. I mean, actually, there is a thing. There is a thing, yeah. And so, location becomes probably the hardest thing. Not so much this part of the country in America, but you probably find anything within a 4 or 5 hour drive. But in some places, you might only have one option as far as style or type of LARP goes, but it's becoming so much more common, you know. Cool. Anything else you wanted to say about your soon-to-be LARP character?
I think I still need convinced. We'll be honest.
Sure.
But the gap is getting maybe smaller.
Would you ever want to just go and, like, observe for, like, an hour or two? Like, let's say there wasn't as much travel or whatever, or you could do something else. You know, would that help, like, just to go and watch? Because they'll, you know, more or less let people, as long as you're not in the way, and, you know, in our game, if you have a white headband, it means you're not really there. So if you're kind of not in the way and just observing,
I actually think it'd be more appealing to go as a character for just, like, an hour or two.
Yeah.
Like, really, like, I can leave.
Yeah. And then, yeah, stay if you're digging it or whatever.
Right, right.
And we have food at our LARP, so at least you could eat or whatever.
Yeah, I guess.
Alrighty. Well, stay tuned to see if we have episode 2 of Kelli's LARPing Adventures.
Thank you for having me.
Of course.
On the podcast.
It's easy because we live together. Alrighty. Thanks for listening. Bye-bye. Is that fun?
Yeah.
Thanks for talking. Appreciate you sharing and eventually LARPing.
You just had to plug that in there.
I'll still love you if you never LARP.
Oh, good.